How's it going, guys? Theo Joe here, and today I'm gonna go over some really cool free programs that I think you guys will find useful, and hopefully you haven't heard of too many of these. I'm sure some of them you have. Now, these are also for Windows, but they may also be available for Mac. Sorry, Mac users, I'm a Windows user. So why don't we just jump right in? Hopefully you find these pretty cool. The first program is called HashTab. It's a very simple program, but also very useful. Now, to understand what it does is, have you ever gone on a website and you go to download a file or something and it says, check the hash before running the file? Basically, what a hash is when you use a certain algorithm to run on the file, and then it generates a string of numbers and letters, and then every time you use that algorithm on that file, it will create the same exact string of numbers. So that means that if you download a file and you check the hash string against what they put, you know it is the exact same file that they are saying you should be downloading. And that can be important for two reasons. First of all, to make sure that the file is not corrupted. And second of all, to make sure that no one malicious went and uploaded maybe the wrong file and it's got a virus in it or something like that. It's basically just a way of making sure that you're downloading exactly what you think. So what this program does is makes it very easy to check hashes. I know for me, I would always see the hash thing and not even know how to check it. It'd be too much of a pain. But now what this program does is when you install it, now every time you right click on a file and go to properties, there's a new tab that shows you all sorts of different hashes that a website might be using. And you can actually select which hashes you want to show up. And it also has a comparison box, so you can just paste the string right in there and it'll tell you whether it's correct or not. So the next time you go to download a file and it has a hash listed, it's very easy to just say, yep, this is exactly what I'm looking for, and you're good to go. The next program is good for people like me who have a hard time staying on task. It's called RescueTime. This is actually a pretty popular program. You guys may have already heard of it. Basically, it lets you keep track of what websites you're going on, what programs you're using, and which of these are distracting and which are productive, so you can keep tabs on how much time you're wasting or how productive you're being. And it's also nice because it can notify you when you've been spending too much time on this or that, and you can keep track of where you're wasting most of your time and address it. Now, for this one, there are actually two versions, the free and the paid version. The free version basically lets you track all your data and stuff like that, whereas the paid version actually allows you to block websites that you determine are distracting, so it gives you a little bit more control. So that's just something to be aware of. All right, so the next program is called Sandboxie, and it's a very useful security program for when you have to deal with suspicious files or anything like that. Like the name suggests, it lets you run files in an isolated sandbox, which basically means that it can't access the rest of the system. So say you download a file from a suspicious source and you're not really sure if it's a virus or not, then you can run it in a sandbox, and even if it is a virus, it won't be able to access any other files on the computer because it's contained in that sandbox. It's pretty similar if you're familiar with virtual machines, except a little bit more convenient. You basically just have to right-click the file and click run a sandbox, and you're good to go. It's definitely something nice to have for when you run across a suspicious file and you don't really want to rely on your antivirus, which aren't always perfect. Though keep in mind, if you're going to use this, it's best used for individual files. If you go to install a program with it, I guess it would work, but then that whole program would be isolated, so you really wouldn't be able to run it except in the sandbox, so it wouldn't be very useful. So it's mostly used for individual files or groups of files that you're not sure of being a virus or something like that. Now, another program related to that topic, which I didn't even include in the top five, this is like a bonus program for you guys, is called Virus Total Uploader. If you haven't heard of Virus Total before, you definitely want to pay attention. This is a great website. I think actually Google bought it, if I'm not mistaken. It's basically a website where you can upload a file and then it automatically scans that with about 50 different antiviruses. And I use that website for basically any time I download a file that I'm kind of suspicious of, and then also use it, of course, with Sandboxie. Now, what the Virus Total Uploader program does is, instead of having to go to the website and click upload and that sort of thing, you just right-click on any file through a context menu after you install it, and then you can upload it right from your computer instantly, basically. Then it just checks the file against all sorts of different antiviruses, and most of the time, if someone has already uploaded that same exact file, then you don't have to wait for it to scan, it'll just tell you the results. And it does that by first taking a hash of the file. Remember, we just talked about those, and if it's the same exact hash, they know, oh, we already scanned this file, here's the hash, here are the results. Then after it's uploaded, you just look down the list and see if any flagged it as a virus. Though you do want to use common sense, sometimes you might see one or two flagged it as a virus from some random antivirus software you've never heard of. So it might be a false positive. Just keep that in mind and use common sense. If pretty much everything says it's fine, but one says it's a virus, still be cautious, but also know that it might be a false positive. All right, so moving on, program number four is Plex. This is an awesome program I love to use. It's great for people who have a lot of videos, movies, TV shows on their computer. What this software will do is import all your video files into a library, and then it will scan them and automatically categorize them by show, movie. It'll automatically gather descriptions, classify it and name the episodes and make it very organized. But more importantly, after you do that, it lets you stream all those files from your computer to any device and watch it on your TV. I think basically all the game consoles these days have a Plex app that you can at least download if it's not natively supported. I know Xbox One S does. I actually have an LG TV that has a Plex app that you can download right from their store. It's a native app and it's really cool. I can stream all my stuff right from my computer without having to download any stuff onto my TV at all. So if all your devices do have a Plex app, then it all just ties together really easily. It does take a little bit of work to set up. You sometimes might have to rename some files manually if they're not organized into folders and stuff like that. Like you might have to put a TV show in different folders by season manually, but once you have it all set up and you have your organization scheme ready to go and you know how it works, it'll just import it basically instantly. Very easy to use. Now, finally is a program I use basically every day, and that is Notepad++, which is basically an infinitely better replacement of Windows Notepad. And this is something I, for example, use when I go to write up video outlines and that sort of thing. And it might look simple, but it has some very good features, much better than the typical just bare bones Notepad. For example, it lets you do programming. So it'll be like an IDE where it will actually highlight syntax and that sort of thing and tell you if there's incorrect syntax. If you import some code, it'll highlight it all nice, make it very easy to read. But of course, it's also got a lot of other nifty features. For example, being able to search several different files at once for specific text. You can say, find all the files in this folder with then mention whatever. And you can also have multiple tabs open for different text documents, which you can't do with Notepad. It also maintains unsaved documents if you close it. So if you're typing up a bunch of stuff, you didn't save it, and you go to close it, and you open it back up, it'll all still be there. Plus, it's got the ability to install plugins, so if there's a feature it doesn't have regularly, there's probably a plugin you can install to get it. So this program is great for when you just want a very simple text editor where MS Word would be overkill, but you still want some really good features. And that's it. Those are five really cool programs that I think you guys will enjoy. Hopefully you didn't hear of all of them already. You found at least one or two that were new to you. So you guys can let me know down in the comment section what you thought. If you've got some other cool programs you want to recommend, let us know down there. And if you did like this video, you thought it was cool, give me a thumbs up so I know you enjoyed it. Also, if you want to subscribe, be sure to do that. I make new videos at least 3 times a week, Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday, so it should be worth it. And if you want to keep watching, I've got some other videos right here you can click on even if you're on a phone. It's a new type of annotation, so that's pretty cool. So again, I'm looking forward to hearing from you guys either here on YouTube or on Twitter as well. So thank you guys for watching. I'll see you next time. Have a good one.